Let me help you out with a few things. First, it's 4 o'clock in the morning here right now. Small arms fire is coming from this way, but more troubling, we're hearing heavy artillery come from the direction of the crash site. Now that's a problem because that region is very hot with conflict and it may make it more difficult for the OSCE and investigators to get in there. So we'll keep monitoring that situation.
Right now we're in the forest within the perimeter of the MH17 flight that went down.
When dawn broke yesterday morning, we were surrounded by bodies still in these fields. Since then, all of those visible bodies have been packed up and taken away.
We have seen developments from the very first day, including now the continuous removal of bodies. And in that context, I can also inform you that earlier today, we were at a railway station a bit out of this location, and we have seen and witnessed ourselves 4 wagons, of which 3 were loaded with what we understand 196 bodies in refrigerated conditions.
For the moment, the train, the carriages where the bodies are refrigerated is stationary. We were given indications that it will remain that way pending the arrival of the international experts, and then from there, decisions will be made where it can go.
Reuters has just released video that appears to show a Ukrainian man there at the scene with a recovered black box.
Мы ждем представителей специализированной организации, в данном случае это ИКАО, которым готовы передать эти предметы технического оборудования самолета.
If the experts decide on their own accord to move in, we are prepared to carry them, but that will be done by their discretion because the OSCD cannot guarantee that security. It will be at their own risk.
Вот сейчас, если не ошибаюсь, уже вот скоро начнется 4-й суд, да, с момента этого происшествия. Вот где эти специалисты? И от Киева сюда дороги на автомобиле 4-5 часов, в зависимости от того, как ехать, с какой скоростью.
You may have heard in the past days sounds of conflict and gunfire in the not far distance. You also know that we are close to what is referred to as a ever-moving front line. So there is, of course, a risk that this area here will be made subject also to this conflict.
Ну, то есть они обещали там какое-то перемирие на время расследование.
А зачем нам их перемирие?
Не знаю.
А их здесь вообще сделать нечего. Чемодан, вокзал России – это в лучшем случае.
Потому, на самом деле, намерения официального Киева пока что сохраняются неизменными. Так сказать, до вот, не с последних сил. Им все равно, сбит самолет, не сбит самолет, погибли люди, не погибли люди. Здесь уже огромное количество людей погибло. Вы поймите, эти 300 человек, почти 300 человек, которые погибли несколько дней тому назад, они не первые и, боюсь, что не последние жертвы невинной этой войны. Здесь погибло огромное количество невинных людей. Таких же мирных граждан. Ну, они не граждане Малайзии, не граждане Нидерландов, да? Они граждане, собственно говоря, официально считались гражданами Украины, а вообще это жители Донбасса. Но это тоже мирные люди, и среди них тоже много женщин и детей. Они погибли, это Киев никак не смущает. Почему гибли еще 300 людей, даже если у них паспорта европейские или малазийские, должна их смутить?
Сука, урод! Пиздец! Саня, давай тачку быстрей.
Today we have reports of drunken separatists, I mean literally drunken separatist soldiers, piling the remains of people, stacking bodies into the back of trucks. Here's what's currently bothering everybody. Drunken separatists have been piling bodies into trucks. The so-called defense minister, self-appointed of the People's Republic of Donetsk, Mr. Igor Strelkov, actually posted a social media bragging about the takedown of a military transport. And then when it became apparent it was civilian, he then quickly removed it from the social media. When, you know, there's a buildup of extraordinary circumstantial evidence. You know, I'm a former prosecutor. I've tried cases on circumstantial evidence. It's powerful here. But even more importantly, we picked up the imagery of this launch. We know the trajectory. We know where it came from. We detected a launch from this area. We have the trajectory recorded. We know they have the system. We know that they had this system to a certainty on Monday the 14th beforehand, because the social media was reporting it and tracking it. Social media, which is an extraordinary tool, obviously, in all of this, has posted recordings of separatists bragging about the shoot down of a plane at the time, right after it took place.
Мы не хотели сбивать самолет, и у нас не было такой технологической возможности, ну физической возможности такой не было. Мы понимаем, что этот самолет сбит украинскими ВВС или украинскими ПВО.
We think this is a wake-up call for countries in Europe. We hope this is a wake-up call for some countries in Europe that have been reluctant to move, because we have 4% of Russia's trade is with the United States. 50% of their engagement is with Europe. So we are trying to encourage our European friends to realize this is a wake-up call. And hopefully they will also join us in these tougher sanctions.
Do we have definitive proof that the Russians were directly involved in the downing of this airliner?
Well, Bob, when you say definitive proof, the Russians, the investigation is going to draw conclusions that are, quote, definitive.